Hey, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna be talking about the regrets that I have as a self-taught software engineer, software developer. Like the things I wish people had told me before I decided to go on this path to being a developer. And hopefully it helps you if you're starting your journey and you're kind of curious about what should I know? What are the things I should learn? What are the things that I should expect when I decide to make the switch to becoming a developer? So I have all my regrets. There's nothing here because I have no regrets. Just kidding, I actually do have a couple of regrets. So the first tip I have is that it's gonna take you a lot longer than 3 months to get your first software developer job. I can't even tell you how frequently when I was on my journey that I saw articles and videos about people who were able to learn how to code and get a job in 3 months. I don't know why 3 months was the amount of time I always saw, but for some reason, I've seen like so many videos about people saying, learn to code and you'll never not have a job, or learn to code and you'll get a job in 3 months. And I feel like there is this idea of this unrealistic length of time that it takes to actually go from having zero knowledge about programming to actually learning how to code. Like, I wish people were more realistic, and at least we heard the stories of people that it took them a little bit longer to get a job as a software developer. Personally, my journey took me like about 9 months, and this was because I'd taken CS courses in college, because I eventually did a program where I was surrounded by other developers, and the program also helped me get referrals to jobs. So all of those things really helped me and made my self-taught path a little bit easier than other people who are going from zero knowledge of coding to learning how to code. Like, I have friends where it took them 9 months, have another friend who it took her 3 years before she could get her first software developer job. So I think that when you're starting your journey, it's really important to know that it's not gonna be a short thing. It's gonna take a long time. It's gonna take a year, sometimes even multiple years, to get your first software developer job. And when you start thinking of this as more of a long-term thing, then you start considering other options. You start thinking about, maybe I should go back to school, or maybe I should get a post-bac degree. Maybe it makes sense to go get my CS degree. Maybe it makes sense to do a bootcamp. When you see it as more of a long-term transition, then I feel like you make different choices and your first instinct isn't to quit your job, learn to code in 3 months and get a job. So yes, I wish the first thing people had told me or first thing I'd known before I decided to do the self-taught path is that it can take a long time, or it can take about a year, sometimes even more, to get a job. So my second tip is that things change really fast in tech. The feeling that you're feeling that there's so much to learn and you have to kind of move very fast pace is a feeling you're gonna feel a lot throughout your journey as a developer. And I wish someone had told me that even though I'm learning Python right now, there are a lot more things that I still have to learn. Like a lot more. Like for example, at my work, when I was preparing for my developer job, I was very familiar with REST APIs and RESTful services. We started first using like REST APIs and very, you know, typical APIs, but then we transitioned into using something called gRPC and learning how to use protobufs and different things like that. So I had to learn a totally different way of creating a service, and that wasn't the only moment. There were many moments that I had to learn something totally different that I didn't know beforehand when I was actually a developer. So it's really important to know that the feeling you're feeling that, oh my God, there's so much to learn, I'm always learning, you're still probably gonna feel the same way when you're a developer. Yeah, I don't know, maybe when you're a senior developer, or maybe when you're like engineering manager, maybe you don't feel that same like, oh my gosh, there's so much to learn feeling, but I definitely just wanna say that you're always gonna feel like there's a lot to learn. And this could be a time to really focus on understanding how you personally learn, what your strategy is to learning things kind of quickly, and how you learn new technologies. Maybe fine-tuning the way you learn is a good strategy. So the third tip regret that I have that I should have done during my self-taught journey was learning how to read other people's code and working with large code bases. When I was learning as a self-taught developer, my goal was learn how to program, data structures and algorithms, build projects, which I talked about in how I became a software developer. But something I should have added into that process was working with other people's code. Because the truth is, when you're actually a developer day to day, very rarely are you the only one working on a singular project. Usually you're working with other people, or you're working with old code, helping to maintain and manage old projects and old code. So you have to get familiar with working with code that's not well maintained, has poor documentation, has poor comments, and like just very difficult to read code. And for me, probably what I should have done during my self-taught journey was do things like contributing to open source projects, maybe doing things like group projects. That could have helped me a lot. Basically, just doing more collaborative coding would have been such a huge help for me in my journey as a self-taught developer. Oh my gosh. So this fourth one, I still have PTSD thinking about how much I had to debug at my old job. Yo, look, my hands are shaking. My hands are shaking. Okay. So yes, debugging is something you'll have to do a lot as a developer. When you're doing your self-taught journey, I really recommend taking a small course or just figuring out smart strategies on how to actually debug. A lot of us know the very straightforward strategy of just copy-pasting your error statement, just tossing it onto Stack Overflow and seeing what the responses say. But the truth is, there is so much that goes into debugging. Learning how to write logging statements, learning how to do system-level debugging, doing test-driven development, like writing tests for every function you have so that your code is more reliable. There's so much that goes into debugging that a lot of people don't talk about, even like reading error statements and knowing how to actually pinpoint what the real error is when you get like paragraph long error statements that you have to understand. So I would really recommend doing a course or just a, not even like a course, maybe like a 30-minute video, learning how to actually debug properly and learning how other people are debugging. So the fifth tip that I could have done a little bit better when I was a self-taught developer is really paying attention to your developer tools, like learning how to actually use your terminal, learning about your editor, all the developer tools that you're gonna use every single day. A lot of us, when you're self-taught, you tend to focus on the technologies you need to build X project. Like if you're a front-end developer, you're like, okay, I'm JavaScript, HTML, CSS, those are the things you're focused on. I feel like a lot of people don't focus on learning about your terminal and like learning about how to optimize your use of your editor. And the truth is, by learning these things, you'll save yourself so much more time in the future because you'll be able to quickly access files, quickly understand what's going on in your code. So I'd also recommend this class called Missing Semesters at MIT. I'm actually taking it right now because I feel like it's really important. I could have done a better job. I could have done it when I was a self-taught developer during my transition. Like I could have totally done this, but I didn't do it. So I would really recommend that you take that class. They also have a debugging class as well. And yeah, that's basically it. Those are the five regrets that I have as a software developer, or five things I wish I had learned, and just general things I wish people had told me before I began my journey. So I hope this video was helpful for you. It was a pretty quick one, but I hope it was helpful, and I'll see you guys next time.